Let's do a warm-up where we figure out the electron configuration of xenon right over here. And then we can use that as the basis for starting to explore the electron configurations of F block elements. And in particular, we'll try to figure out the electron configuration of neodymium. I always have trouble pronouncing these. Neodymium, I believe, is how it's pronounced. So let's first work on xenon. I encourage you to actually pause the video and try to come up with the electron configuration for xenon on your own. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it, so we can just go through it. So it's going to be 1s2, 1s2, then we go to the second period, 2s2, and then we're going to the 2p subshell, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2p6, then 3s2, then 3p6, 3p6, then we go 4s2, and now we are in the D block. And remember, in the D block, even though we're in the fourth period, we're going to actually fill in the 3D subshell. We take the period minus 1, so it's going to be 3D. And to fill it up, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 3D 10. Then you're back in the P block, and since you're in the fourth period, it's going to be 4P, and once again, to fill it up, you have 6 electrons. And then we go to the fifth period, 5s2. And then we're going to go, the period is 5, but we're in the D block. So we're going to go back to the 4D subshell, 4D10. And then we come back, and xenon perfectly fills out the 5P subshell, 5P6. So that's the electron configuration of xenon. So now let's think about what the electron configuration of neodymium is. So one thing that you're saying, hey, what's going on with this F block right over here? It's just kind of this island of elements. And it's really not an island. The reason why they put these colors here is because the F block actually belongs right here. And if people had more width on pages to display these periodic tables, they would shove the D and the P blocks over to the right and stuff the F blocks right over here. And we actually did that. And I actually like to look at it that way because it makes it clear it's not really an island. It actually kind of fits in the pattern of the periodic table. That this right over here is our F block. So that is our, this right over here is our F block. So given that, let's figure out the electron configuration for neodymium. And I'll give you a hint. In the D block, you go back and backfill one shell below the period that you're in. In the F block, you go back 2 shells. So here, we're not filling out the 6F subshell, and not even the 5F subshell, but the 4F subshell. So given that, figure out how much more do we have to add. How much more do we have to go past xenon in order to get its electron configuration? So I encourage you to pause the video and figure that out right now for neodymium. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it. So neodymium is going to have the electron configuration of xenon. So xenon gets us right over here. It's the highest atomic number noble gas that has a smaller atomic number than neodymium. And so we can start with that, which we already saw was fairly involved. And then to that, we just add the incremental higher energy electron. So now we're in the sixth period. So we're going to go 6s2. That's that right over there. That's 6s2. And now we're going to start going into the F subshell, but it's not going to be in the 6 shell. It's going to go 2. It's going to be our period minus 2. So it's going to be 4. Let me do this in a color you can see. So this is going to be, we are 4 electrons into that subshell. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's going to be 4F4. So we're in the 6th period, but since we're in the F block, we're going to go backfill into the 4th shell. That's the fourth shell right over there. And we are 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons into it. And so this is a pretty neat shorthand, because the other way to write the electron configuration of neodymium would have been to do this, would have been to write down all of this. So let me do that. To have all of this, let me copy and paste it. Actually, I think that's going to take up too much space. Let's see. So to write all of that, so copy and paste. To write all of that, and then to add to that the 6s2, and the 4f4. And so hopefully you appreciate that this is a slightly more efficient way to write it.